Hi, I'm Sean Connolly, a product designer here at Crema, and today we're asking the question, does Figma work on iPad? And if, like myself, you're a fan of Betteridge's Law of Headlines, you already know the answer, but we're going to ask it anyway. A number of people at Crema use their iPads all throughout their workflow. I know PMs use them a lot for note-taking. We do some testing on iPad. And I do a bit of design work on iPad really early on, maybe some sketching on a sketch app with an Apple Pencil. But lately I've been thinking, well, how cool would it be to do the entire workflow from sketches on a sketching app all the way through a full-fledged designed product? So a bit ago, George and I dove into Figma. Well, it was my first time diving into Figma. I think he had seen it before, but I was really blown away about the potential that it had. So using it on iPad and having this like really slimmed down version of a workflow, I thought would be really cool. And actually it's funny because here's my my laptop, which is the same size as my iPad. So really it's not anything more than like, wouldn't it be cool? There's like a lot of horsepower in this MacBook Pro and not so much in the iPad Pro. So I thought that would be a really cool thing to test. This just seems like it's a little bit more mobile, although it's not much. So iPad now runs its own operating system. It used to be iOS, but they've differentiated that a bit. And now they support a mouse. So you can have a cursor on your screen. And Safari is now a full-fledged like desktop version of the app. So with that, I thought, wow, I mean, Figma's totally web-based. Like, why wouldn't this work? I can use a mouse now. And I dove into it, and I think there are a couple cool things about connecting all of these pieces. So we can take a look at that. Okay, enough context, let's get started. The way we're going to start is connecting our mouse for the first time. Now, I've already done this, so some of the settings might be a bit different. But to start, we just go to accessibility. So I think this is kind of interesting. Apple has sort of incorporated a mouse and a cursor into the workflow, but it's meant to be an accessibility feature. So we go into touch, and it's called assistive touch. So if we turn that on, you'll see my mouse, just my cursor appears here. And it looks totally different than what you're used to seeing. It's a little round indicator. And again, I think it's really meant to mirror like touching and tapping on the screen. So it's kind of this round interface. And what's cool here is that you have a bunch of options, and I've already done a bit of customization to my my cursor. So as you can see, my mouse is connected here, and I like it because if you can see, I don't know if you can see, but I can connect up to three different devices to the single mouse. I just simply switch between them with a button. So I use it on my Mac and my iPad. But a couple customization things that I've already done, I made the cursor as small as I possibly could. And so it's still pretty large, but I think it starts maybe somewhere around here, which is huge. But again, it's not too different than a finger, but you can blow this thing way up. So I have mine really small, and I turned off auto hide. So that means after 3 seconds, the cursor will disappear, but as I've connected the mouse, I want it to always be connected. So I can turn that off and it won't go away. And the only other thing is that the assistive touch means that this little menu down here has to be present, but you can either reduce the opacity of that or turn it off completely as long as the mouse is connected. So to do that, that's just right here. It's just this on-screen menu and we can turn that off. Connecting the mouse, it's a really cool start. We'll see what we can do with it. So here we are now in the Figma application, as you would know it on any other desktop browser. The mobile version looks different. I can show you that in a second. But we'll start a new project. And here we just have a clean slate. And the first thing we do is add a frame. So I'm just gonna tap F to draw a frame, and here we go. This is the trial right here. All right, folks, let's see. We have a 28 by 28 pixel frame, and that's not gonna work for anything. Yeah, there it is. So what you'll see is like I'm tapping F to start a frame, I'm dragging it, and I get a couple pixels in, and for whatever reason it locks up. I have no idea why, other than, again, this mouse and the cursor on the screen. The iPad sort of interprets that as a finger on a screen, and so you can imagine you'd want to pan around this canvas, and there's really no other way to do that when you don't have a trackpad and things like that. So it tries to draw for you, it tries to draw a shape for you, but then it locks up and then it starts dragging the canvas around. So again, it's like it thinks there's a finger on the screen. Another thing too, I have the type keyboard, which I love. And if I were to hold command, I could zoom in and out, but that doesn't work here. You'd have to pinch. So you have to pinch to zoom in and out. Could be kind of a cool workflow if you're, you know, using your hand over here a bit and then using your mouse over here. I don't know, maybe it sounds a bit chaotic that way. So here we are, so we've added a frame. Now you can still manipulate some of this stuff. It's a bit finicky, so look, I can grab that. We can move it around the board. We can make, we can make the size. So we can make the size where we want it to be. So this is gonna be a desktop, oh man. Let's see, and that's 2 pixels. I can't select that. Okay, there we go. And we can blow that up to 900. Here we go. So that's like a normal frame if you'd want to maybe do something on desktop. It took us a long time to get to this point. You would never want to use iPad for Figma as it stands. I guess that's our answer. It's really cool that you can see it all in this way. And you totally can go to like the read-only version, which is like the mobile version, and I'll show you that. So I have one pulled up on Chrome. We'll pull up an existing project. Because this is the mobile version of Chrome, there's no like panels on either side to actually manipulate the content, but you can zoom in and kind of see everything. Let's see what you can do in this. Yeah, you can't do much in this view here. So it's totally the mobile version, whereas you saw in Safari, it's the desktop version kind of presented in a mobile view. We can still view prototypes and click through clickable prototypes. So I'll open up this one right here. We'll go view that, so it'll open up a new tab. Cool. So this works a lot like you were touching the screen. And in fact, because it's an iPad, I can touch the screen, so that's kind of cool. Kind of gives you another level of connection to the designs you're making. This is a mobile app we're looking at, so it's kind of cool to be able to touch the screen there. So here we are back on our little temporary trial canvas. We can start to try to draw shapes. Yeah, so shapes don't work. Frames are the only thing that seemingly works, and then sometimes they just stop working. So I can't do anything there. Let's see if we can add text. Nope. What can we do? Can we select that frame? We can select it here in the side menu, so that's cool. And we could change the color of the background. Awesome. Or can we? Struggling. I can't click this. So then some things are broken. Okay, cool. I can click that. There we go. Did that. Cool. Can I make it a component? Yes, I can. Cool. So we can do some things, but not much. And you would never want to use this in your actual design flow. So the moral of the story is Figma in its current state does not work on iPad or iPadOS, but I think there's a huge opportunity there. It would be really cool to use a web app on iPad and do the design workflow from start to finish. So iPadOS is brand new, maybe a couple weeks old, and I'm still very new to Figma. So if anybody has dug through the accessibility settings or knows any way to get Figma to work on iPad, please leave a comment below. I would love to know how that works. I would love to be able to start designing in a sketch app and bring it all the way to fruition in Figma. Okay, and that's all I have. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe for more content like this.